Like many hockey players that make it to the big leagues, Jonas Korpisalo wasn't the first in his family to play professional hockey, as his father Jari spent 12 seasons playing for the Finnish league Liiga, and also the DEL. Several seasons later, Jonas followed in his father's footsteps by also playing professionally in the top league in Finland after being selected by the Columbus Blue Jackets in 2012, 62nd overall. After Jari hung up the skates for good, however, he spent over a decade taking on various roles of management for multiple Liiga teams. Even more interestingly, the elder Korpisalo, during his playing career, ended up playing for the same Finnish junior team as Jarmo Kekäläinen, Columbus's current GM. "Wherever he goes in the city, everyone knows him," Jonas says. "He was quite the character when he played, so people remember him. He was a hothead, scoring goals and stuff like that. That's a rare combination, to have fighting and scoring goals. It was old school hockey," he says. Even though when Jonas, growing up, took an immediate interest in hockey, which definitely delighted his old man, his preference in position initially didn't. "I remember I liked all the goalie gear when I was younger," Jonas recalls. "I remember I was rather young, like 8 or 9, the first time I tried being a goalie. I remember trying it out for the first time and I was like, wow, this is actually pretty cool. I tried it more and more. I think I was like 10 years old or something. I was like, okay, I'm going to play hockey and I'm a goalie." I remember my dad was like, "You can still try out and be a forward or something," he says. Well, obviously for this Tendi, the position choice proved to be ideal. At least for Columbus anyway. Most hockey players have various pre-game routines and superstitions. It's just common knowledge. And when you're a goalie, the tendency to be particular pretty much just comes with the position. CBJ starter didn't claim to be ritualistic when being asked if he does have his own strict pre-game and in-game regimens that he lives by. "It starts after the morning skate on a game day," he says. "I go take a nap, eat the same thing, take my stick, and then get a cup of coffee. I always do those things in the same order. I have the same warm-up every time. And during games, every 5 minutes, I try to splash water on my face to keep me awake. It's pretty mental, I guess," he says. Upon his start for Columbus at home for a regular season meeting against the Bruins in 2016, Korpisalo would not only be facing one of the better teams of the Atlantic Division, but also one of his role models in Tuukka Rask. Even though there's only 7 years between the two Tendis, age-wise, Korpisalo recalls post-game after facing the previous Vezina recipient for the first time and not coming off with a W, the experience was still pretty ideal. "It was pretty cool seeing him. I was always looking up to him. He was kind of my biggest idol when I was growing up, and it was pretty cool to play against him. I really like his style, and I try to copy him," he says. But it wasn't until around 2 years later that number 70 finally tasted victory against his fellow netminder.
Tuukka Rask is a guy I'm sure you look up to. I know you train with him a little bit in the summertime. He's down at the other end. You're watching him. It didn't look like you were intimidated whatsoever. You just went out and played your game tonight.
Yeah, I've been looking up to Tuukka since he came to NHL. He was my, you know, the guy who I was looking up to, and it's fun to play against him and other Finns too, and I think it's the first time I won against him, so it feels good.
The NHL playoffs are never predictable, as we all know, but as Korpisalo and his team prepared to face their first round opponent in the Lightning for Game 1, they probably didn't suspect that some of them would be rewriting history. As a game that began mid-afternoon ended up becoming the fourth longest NHL game to have ever been played. Even though the Finnish goaltender wasn't able to stop the shot from Braden Point in the fifth overtime period, he was still able to shatter records. As he made his 74th save of the contest, became the goaltender with the most saves ever recorded in a single game in league history.